Can't smoke in public, can't smoke in private. As we inch closer to the legalization of marijuana, more and more condo dwellers are being forbidden from smoking up in their own homes. So many condo boards in Toronto are fully banning the use of weed, and not just in common places, but on balconies and inside private units. Tonight on the Marijuana Files, we take a look at your rights as a legal pot smoker.
We don't have to disclose to our board if we're having alcohol in our unit, so isn't pot supposed to be being treated the same way? It just seems like there's a lot of kind of, I guess, scare tactics when it comes to this new legalization, and it looks like my condo board doesn't quite know what to do with it.
Condo owner Kaylee Aline reached out to City News concerned over this notice that was delivered to her mailbox. Without consultation, she says her condo board put a ban on pot smoking and growing pot in her building. She calls the move bizarre, since residents can still smoke cigarettes.
I own my unit, and you know, when there starts to be rules on this, how, I guess, where does the madness end? Like, where are there going to be more rules on other stuff? Is there going to be kind of more restrictive regulations with noise curfews? Are they going to be, you know, coming into our units to double check? Like, what does that mean for our privacy and our ownership of these units?
In her condo's case, there is an exemption for medical marijuana, but Kaylee says that raises other issues.
No, and now you have to tell them your medical history? I feel like that's really intrusive.
Right. Are your phones ringing off the hook?
All day, every day.
Danielle Schwartz is with Lash Condo Law. Her firm gives advice to condo boards on how to handle legalization. We have heard some extreme cases of condo boards saying we're going to ban edibles, we're going to ban growing pot plants, we're going to ban deliveries. Where is the line in all of this, and what is enforceable?
So the line is that all rules have to be reasonable under the Condo Act. So there's two criteria. You can do rules to promote the safety, security, and welfare of the people and of the building. As long as the rules are deemed to be reasonable, they can be passed.
When it comes to people who own or rent these condos, what rights do they have if they don't agree?
So owners have the ability to what's known as a requisition. So when the rules are passed, there's a 30-day period where owners can requisition a meeting to challenge the rules that are passed. So rules aren't effective until 30 days if they haven't received a requisition.
Well, Kaylee is hoping that once smoking marijuana becomes mainstream, some of the strict rules surrounding it will begin to loosen.
Are you ready for this?
The Marijuana Files. Coverage continues daily on City News.